Molly's Game is directed by Aaron Sorkin in his directorial debut and stars Jessica Chastain, Idris Elba, Kevin Costner and Michael Cera. Chastain stars as Molly Bloom, a former Olympic hopeful who gets offered the chance to oversee a massive high-stakes poker game with film stars, directors, CEOs, all sorts of people playing, and eventually gets more neck-deep in it than a gay man in Saudi Arabia, ending up being in the shit for some of her players having ties to a Russian mob. It's also based on a memoir by the real Molly Bloom. This is a true story. And Aaron Sorkin has written a lot of very good films, I've heard, although this is the first time he's been the director as well. And for a first-time director, he did as good of a job as you could expect. He really captured the atmosphere of his sleazy nightclub and the nightlife of two massive cities, as if I don't know what either of them are like. And it's impressively shot, especially the poker scenes, although I could have done without the stupid slideshow arrows and picture explanations of the poker deck, just to make sure my stupid brain absorbed it into my stupid head. It's also beautifully acted, especially from Chastain and Elba. Molly, she, you get the sense she's in over her head at times, but eventually she gets the hang of it. She becomes more smart, more streetwise, and you can still see she doesn't really mean any harm. And Jessica Chastain, she portrayed it perfectly. Same goes for Idris Elba, her lawyer. He's the exact type of lawyer you'd want representing you, someone you don't have to worry about getting you into more trouble, someone who'll just lay out all the facts for you, just lay them out like a picnic blanket, perfectly patterned. That's as far as that analogy goes, I think. And he gets really aggressive in his defense sometimes, because one of the best things about this film is the morals here, wondering whether or not Molly actually did anything wrong. Sure, she can be convicted for all this, but can you consider her morally or ethically responsible? Because, the law isn't always squeaky clean, and as any protest will probably tell you, as they kick up the biggest fuss about whether or not it's illegal to sell your eyeballs in Texas, which is actually a real law, look it up. And in that sense, it came off to me as a lot like Breaking Bad, but with poker. It also had some really good dialogue, also courtesy of Aaron Sorkin. As for flaws, sometimes the plot left me in the dust a bit, also like a gay man in Saudi Arabia, I gave us the last time we'll use that. But I'm willing to give the film the benefit of the doubt and assume that's because I don't know much about law and even less about poker, so I'll let that slide. What isn't getting a turn on the slide until he apologises for thinking I'm stupid is the narration. Films told through cross-cutting, keep swapping back and forth from past to present and the trial to the games. That's fine. That can be an interesting way to tell the story. But every scene in the past that is, telling Molly's story before she started getting convicted and having allegations thrown at her, and, they all start out by just narrating, by Molly narrating it. It just dumps exposition on you for a few minutes and then just lets it play out naturally. And it just would have been better if they just dumped the narration for the most part, because that's all it was. They just vomit exposition at you for a few minutes and then it gets back to the good stuff. And also, the ending's incredibly anticlimactic for what they were setting up. I mean, I'm assuming that's because, this is how Molly Bloom's actual trial went down. But it's the film stars don't die in Liverpool thing again, where just a bit of artistic license could have made a much better ending and a much more satisfying ending. However, Molly's Game's a far better film than that one with the overly annoying and long title, and a pretty fine start to 2018. It's 2018. Okay, where I am. I'm going to give Molly's Game an 8 out of 10. Check this one out if you haven't already, and yeah, like I just said, every review from now until the end of the year is under the banner of 2018 movies, because they all came out in the UK, or rather than 2018. I know this came out late last year in America. Just wanted to clarify in case this ends up on my top 10 for this year. Might do, might not. So, guys, have you seen Molly's Game? What did you think about it? Or what's your favorite poker film? Whatever it is, let me know. Thanks for watching. Have a good one.